What's up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome to the longest running series on my channel, the COD History, the Sunday Call of Duty Top 10. And you're probably wondering, this isn't the Top 10, your face is here, this isn't normal, we've never seen this. Well, I decided to change things up and do it as a live commentary for you guys. We're going to go over the Top 10, we're going to read the tweets, the Discord messages, and see if you guys enjoy it. If you like this format better than the old format, let me know. Maybe we'll do it again in the future. And as always, the Sunday Top 10 is powered by Scuf. That's right, not just the controllers, the accessories, the apparel, anything you get over there. Use promo code CHAOS, get yourself a discount, and make sure you tweet at me and let me know you did. Link is at the top of the description. And now, today we're going to do something a little different on top of the face cam. We're going to go back to Modern Warfare 3. And I tweeted you guys and asked you on my Team Chaos Discord, which a link is in the description to both of those. Follow me on Twitter. Go over there and join the Team Chaos Discord. What was your favorite thing about Modern Warfare 3? And the nostalgia just came flooding back. When you guys started tweeting and posting, I just remembered all kinds of cool things. And there are so many people that hold Modern Warfare 3 in such high regards. And I didn't really realize that. I thought people didn't like it. It wasn't quite a finished game. I knew some people liked it, but I had no idea that there were so many people passionate about so many things with Modern Warfare 3. So today, we're going to be counting those down. If you're new to this Sunday Top 10, it's real simple. It's a community-driven Top 10. You guys decide what is going to be on it. And as always, there will be some honorable mentions. So I've talked enough. Let's get into it. Be sure to enter the monthly $200 Amazon gift card here on the channel. It's really easy to enter. All you have to do is like the video, make sure you're subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications for a chance to win. Leave a comment why you want it with your Twitter handle, and I will pick the winner at the end of the month. Good luck. All right, kicking off our list at number 10 is from Bug Leader Matt on Twitter, and he says, okay, so Modern Warfare 3 has some awesome customization for custom games. I made my own up and then I played with my friends, which was a gun game with half slots being riot shields and half javelins. It could go on forever. It was frustrating, but I found it funny too. I did at least, and that is my memory. Customization, custom matches in Modern Warfare 3 was a huge thing. Look, he made a gun game with half riot shields and half javelins. That's absolutely crazy. And so many people made so many different dynamic games that I totally agree. This definitely deserved to be on the list today. Moving right along to number 9. We're going to stay on Twitter for this one. Matt Shooter Guy 72. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. The gun variety. There were so many guns within each category. I believe that it was the most we've had in any COD game. Now, I could have focused in on guns because a lot of you tweeted and messaged me and said the MP7 or the MSR or just a ton of different guns in the game, the PP90. But this is a good tweet to encompass all of them. The gun variety in the game was pretty insane. There was ARs that you could use. There were SMGs that you could use. There were shotties. I mean, the Striker. Holy crap, the freaking Striker. Sniping. So many people liked sniping in this game, not to mention the FMG9s, which were absolutely just crazy. There were a ton of options. The ACR, the, what was it, CM901, the SCAR. I think the SCAR was in this game. There was a ton of options that you could use in this game when it came to gun variety. And now that I look back and think about it, he's right. I think it's probably the most that we've ever seen in a Call of Duty game. All right, at number 8 from Johnny Rutegia on Twitter. Simple, two words. Pro perks. Well, two words in a hashtag. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. Pro perks. Do you guys remember pro perks? Now, I know we have the division and that type of structure now in Call of Duty World War II, but do you remember pro perks from Modern Warfare 3? That, I don't know. I'm kind of wanting pro perks to come back. You guys let me know if you agree. If you disagree, you have your base perk, and then you upgrade it to a pro perk and you get extra stuff. Marksman was one of them. I mean, there were so many different pro perks in the game that I liked it. It gave you more adaptability. I know people want perks back in Black Ops 4, whatever you get. There's some people that like the division and the basic training in COD World War II, but there's a lot of people that just feel that it's native to Call of Duty and they want to go back to perks. So I want to know, do you like pro perks or just the regular perk system? But either way, I think we'll see perks in the next Call of Duty. It feels like Call of Duty. All right, on Twitter, Claudius Neo says, hashtag Chaos Top 10, Drop Zone was one of the few fun modes in the game. had hard point aspects, and you get a whole bunch of streaks to use and destroy your opponents with. Now, I'm going to disagree with you, Mr. Claudius Neo. It is not one of the few fun modes, because we have modes we're going to be talking about throughout this, and now that I look at it, hindsight's 2020, Modern Warfare 3 had more fun game modes than any Call of Duty to date, if you ask me, and Drop Zone is just one of them. You can add the tweet we did earlier about customization and doing custom lobbies, but we have many, many more to cover that some people may have actually forgotten about. But yes, Drop Zone was a ton of fun, but trust me, there's more than just this one. Moving right along to number 6, and a lot of people forgot about this, okay? Adam McLaughlin says, hashtag Chaos Top 10, DLC. I love the way the DLC dropped. We haven't seen anything like this since they did it. They had a DLC calendar. Do you guys remember this? Do you remember Elite, or whatever the Elite site was, or whatever? Anyway, 9 content packs over 9 months instead of 4 DLC packs every month. Included some pretty sweet Spec Ops missions. Black Ice was super fun. So basically, you had this calendar where you were literally getting DLC drops once a month. And it was a calendar. It lasted for 9 months. Now, I know the traditional DLC packs are, we get a DLC, we get 4 of them. Usually have 4 multiplayer maps, a zombie map, whatever. Well, now, 3 multiplayer maps, a war map, and a zombie map. But it'll probably go back to traditional. But I wouldn't have any problem with them going and trying out this calendar version that they did with Modern Warfare 3. I personally enjoyed it because you were getting the steady dose every month of some DLC for the game. I don't know. I like this, and I actually forgot about this until he tweeted it out. Okay, cracking into the top 5 over on the Discord, we got Riker, and he says, hashtag Chaos Top 10. It has to be survival mode. It gave me endless hours of fun. I could tackle the mission so many ways that it would make each playthrough different. Now, everybody loves zombies, and I get it, but before, well, not before zombies, but in that mix, you had survival mode, and it was very strategic. I played this for hours, and when you got to the juggies, it was really, really tough. However you set up your launchers, your sentry turrets, there was a lot of thought that went into this game, and I know it was a more simplistic version than what we have now with zombies and what we've seen in the past, but it was a ton of fun, and I wouldn't have any problem with it coming back, but I don't think it's going to, because you know we're getting zombies, and we're probably going to get a battle royale mode as well, so there's probably not going to be much room for something like survival, but so many of you tweeted and posted in the Discord, it made the number 5 spot. At number 4, let's stay on Discord with Lord of Death. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. Definitely killing Makarov. After he took you on a hell of a ride, which included killing Soap and Yuri, spoiler alert, you finally kill him. By the way, he deserves it. Watching Price light the cigarette at the end was the icing on the huge cake. I'm not going to just say the death of Makarov. I'm going to say the entire campaign. It was a roller coaster ride. There were ups, there were downs. Soap died. Yuri died. The end of it was so fulfilling. Like he said, when you freaking lit your cigarette, not even your cigarette, it wasn't a cigarette, it was a freaking cigar, and it was all over. It was the culmination of one of the best trilogies we'll probably ever see when it comes to Call of Duty. So yeah, I'm just going to say the whole campaign. At number 3 over on Twitter, Troy Colors Rev says it has to be the specialist perk system. You got rewarded if you went on a kill streak. If you got 7 kills in a row, you got every perk in the game. That plus ACR equals Moab. So we're going to encompass 2 here. We're going to say the specialist perk system, which I know a ton of people loved. A lot of you tweeted. And we're going to include the Moab, which a lot of people said as well. You guys remember when this came out and YouTube, it changed. We got Moab Mentators. We got Call of Duty channels that blew up strictly by posting Moabs. It started with 1 Moab. Then it was a double. Then it was a triple. Then it was a whatever the heck, a quad Moab and a quinta Moab. I don't even know. It got to the point where people were getting like 5 and 6 Moabs a game. It was absolutely insane. So yeah, we're going to say the specialist perk system, which did. It turned you into a superhero basically on the battlefield, and the Moab. At number 2, we've got Christian Berrios, and he says, when they implemented 1v1, 2v2, and 3v3 in small maps, good times. Everybody's forgotten about this. He's talking about face-off maps, another mode that has just been swept under the rug. Do you guys remember, what was it, Vortex? You're out on a farm, and there's tornadoes, and it's 2v2, 3v3. I loved these things. I know a lot of people didn't. I know a lot of people said they got abused, and people would camp, but I spent so much time on these. And we've never seen them since. It has been years since we have seen 1v1 face-off maps or 2v2 face-off maps, really small maps. If you never played these, go back and try to play. They're probably not populated, so you probably can't. But man, we need these back. They can fix what people didn't like about them. But this was a good idea. Just for some reason, it didn't stick. But I absolutely loved it. And finally, at number one today, it wasn't even close, guys. Yeah, LaGoy, yeah, says, Modern Warfare 3, the first COD game with Infected, and it was brilliant. It has been in every Infinity War game ever since, and it was also a part of AW. I really hope they bring it back in World War II, because it would be awesome to have some permanent party game modes in this year's. Okay, so he wants it in Call of Duty World War II now. But yeah, I mean, Infected. So many of you tweeted Infected. It was the first time we've ever seen it in Call of Duty, and you guys fell in love with it. It definitely garnered the number one spot today on the list, but we're not done. I've got two honorable mentions for you guys. One from Scruffy Fox on Twitter, hashtag ChaosTop10. Honestly, has to be the best times playing Team Defender. I told you guys, game mode after game mode, Face Off, Team Defender, Infected, Survival, Drop Zone. We could go on and on and on. Love the support kill streaks, getting an escort airdrop every match, and most of the time it dropped a juggy, and you had the flag, amazing time with buddies. And the other one is from Milzy on Twitter, the sniping. Every sniper in that game was smooth. Between the Barrett and the MSR, you couldn't go wrong. My personal favorite sniping experience. A lot of you said that you loved the sniping in Modern Warfare 3, which I guess was pretty underrated. So there you go, guys. Those are 10 of the best things from Modern Warfare 3. If you guys want to see us do another Call of Duty, let me know. If you want to see me keep the face cam, let me know. Drop a like if you do, or let me know in the comment section, yes or no. And that's it. I hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you tonight for Gaming Top 10.